Morning. Hope you're doing well today. Another beautiful morning with our God sitting upon a throne and ready to reach down and bless us today and take care of us and provide for us. What an awesome God we serve today. I want to look today in Luke chapter 6, verse 46 through 49. Luke chapter 6, verse 46 through 49. But why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not do the things which I say? Whoever comes to me and hears my sayings and does them, I will show you whom he is like. He is like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation on the rock. And when the flood arose, the stream beat vehemently against a house and could not shake it, for it was founded upon the rock. But he who heard and did nothing is like a man who built a house on the earth without a foundation, against which the stream beat vehemently, and immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great. Here Jesus is talking, and he said, build on the rock, have a firm foundation. And he's asking these people, why do you call me Lord and do not the things which I say? Why do you say, I guess, in word only pretending to be a child of God, but in actions and deeds and the life that you're living and the words of my in my book that you don't obey? He said, let me tell you what it's like. He said, if you obey my words, if you follow me and you ask me to forgive you of your sins and let me live with you, and in you, he said, oh yeah, you have put your foundation upon the rock. And yes, there will be storms. There will be times of trouble. There will be times of trials. But you know what's going to happen? It may come and beat and blow and threaten to tear down everything you got. But because you're upon the rock, because you have Jesus Christ living with you, that house will continue to stand. He didn't say we wouldn't have storms. He didn't say we wouldn't have troubles. But he said, when they come, and they will come, you will be held firm because you are built upon the foundation that is Jesus Christ and his word. And he told other people, he said, now, if you come and say, Lord, Lord, and you've heard my words, but you do not heed them, you do not obey them, you do not live by them, let me tell you what you're going to be like. Oh, you're going to build a house. But you're not going to dig deep to the rock. You're just going to build it out there on the land and on the earth, he said. And when the storms come and the life's trials come, life's heartaches come, and they begin to beat upon you, you're not going to have the hand of God there upon you to hold you up in that storm. You're not going to have the help that comes in knowing Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And he says, that house will fall. That house will be torn down. So my friends, today, you must choose which way you're going to go. Oh, you can say, Lord, Lord, I love you, Jesus. I love you. I'm in the church. I work in the church. I go to church. I do this in your name. But all that's good. But unless you have been forgiven of your sins, unless you have received Christ as your Lord and Savior, that is the only way you'll have him to help in the time of trouble. That's the only way your house will stand upon the face of that rock whenever the world comes against you. Just going through the motions in word only does not anything for you as far as having God's help and God's support. So my friend, today, why not choose Christ? Why not surrender your life to him? Build upon the rock, which is Jesus Christ and his word, so that you can have that help in the time of trouble. You will stand in the time of the storm. Don't put it off. We know not what today holds for the rest of the day. We know not what tomorrow holds or next week. But storms are going to come. Life is going to come. Sometimes life just gets bad and gets hard and gets rough. But friends, if you're a child of God today, we can be rest assured and have no fear that in the midst of those storms, Jesus Christ will be there to calm us. Thank you, Lord, today, for that promise. If we will live by your word and hold you in our arms and call you the Lord of our life and surrender our life to you, God, you're there to hold us up in the midst of the storms and the troubles and bring us through victoriously. And Lord, we thank you for that promise today in your precious name. Amen. May God bless you today is my prayer.